My name is Louis Perot. I'm from Mount Vernon, New York. I'm 24 years old now. I went to the University of Albany, SUNY Albany, up at school. Joined a dance team called Nemesis and pretty much started my dance career from there.
When did you become interested in dance?
I always had some type of interest in dance in high school, but like there wasn't really much dance teams out in my high school, so like I never really like pursued it. And I knew once I got to college that was something that if anything I want to do, I wanted to join a dance team. When I first transferred to Albany a year after I started college, everything would just went completely wrong. Like my housing was messed up, my classes were messed up. I don't know if I could get, you know, everything situated. But the one thing that went right is that I got onto a dance team when I auditioned, and then from there everything kind of fell into place. I knew I actually made friends on a dance team, and they kind of helped me get my schooling situation and stuff together. And then from there I just kind of ran with it.
And what were some of your trials and tribulations throughout your career?
My dance career, my school career.
Both.
Let's see. When I transferred to school, I was gonna sign up for classes and get an apartment the same day. So when I signed up for classes, because they didn't have housing for me at school, the apartment didn't accept me for whatever reason. She just changed her mind. So I actually was going to school with no classes for the first 2 weeks. I was driving up to Albany 2.5 hours, taking my class or going home. Or if I had class the next day, I'd sleep in my car and then go to class the next day from there. So it was kind of like a crazy experience. Wow, like you're going to school and you don't have a place to live type thing. And I tried out for the team, and then when I made it, they called me. I told my kid to go to the social or whatever that they were going to have. Then because of my situation, they actually helped me find housing and get in touch with people to get housing or get my apartment and get housing on the school. So that's how I kind of fell into place. So since the team helped me, I kind of took it as my initiative to kind of get back and stick with the team. And then from there, I just found out I love dance. Loved it. And I went through a few injuries, knee injuries and stuff like that throughout dance. But I mean, thankfully, I was still able to, you know, recover and still perform. And then from there, I started dancing in 2006 on Nemesis. So I graduated in 2010. And just from those 4 years, just like shot, there was lots of ups and downs. But I mean, some of the definite highs. The following year, we competed in 106 in Park, and we won that, which was like amazing. And then the following year after that, we went to America's Best Dance Crew auditions. And you know, like when I became president of the team, I just kind of just wanted to take the team up. It was just also not so much about me, but I was just really just getting better with the team, just making the team sort of new heights. And then from there, I realized my talents, that I really do have a talent for dance. So
once you realize that as an individual dancer, what started to happen, like some of your big accomplishments?
Right, well, once I graduated, as I was in my year of graduation, I was kind of more so not focused on passing on the team, not so much as being president. I still was there helping them, but I knew transitioning out of the team, I'd want to become a solo dancer. So from there, I started to work on my choreography and just try to get better. I ended up, in December of 2010, I ended up auditioning and then working with an up and coming artist and his new label to back up dance for him, and I started making his choreography. And then after that was over, I actually networked and ended up in a Beyonce video, the Move Your Body video, the Get Me Body remake, which was like,
that's my goal.
That was amazing. Such a great experience. I'm still shocked at how it happened, but that was another really positive experience that I encountered.
I would like for you to talk about, and when I say talk about, speak to directly to the youth about that experience. Talk about how you carried yourself, you know, as an individual, your professionalism, and let them know that it wasn't just all about dancing. It's a whole lifestyle, it's a whole culture that you have to live in order for you to move forward in this dance business, because it is a business.
It definitely is a business. And going to places like BET and even America's Best Dance Crew auditions, you know that you see firsthand that it's not all about just dancing. Oh, you know, who has the best moves? It's definitely not all about that. It has part to do with it, but it's definitely more of a business. You have to carry yourself. It's more, the most important thing I can say with dancing, and I can speak for myself, is networking. Know how to carry yourself as a business person and network and market yourself. Because if you're not going to market yourself, nobody else is going to do it for you. Unless you pay for that's what you have an agent for. But it's just more so just understanding like what goes on, talking to people, finding out, you know, really just taking it almost as like another class in school, just kind of trying to educate yourself about it. Talk to as many people as you can to get to know, you know, what you can do in the dance industry, how to get into it, and, you know, things you need to do to kind of better yourself as a dancer. And as an overall business person, so that way you can become skilled the way you want to know.
What are you currently doing now? Or what do you currently want to do now with your career?
I definitely want to, as a dancer, I really want to be a choreographer. That's why I really want to be more so a choreographic artist. I also want to, you know, have a chance to perform, but I enjoy more so putting together performances and big packages like that, being in the behind the scenes crew. So I don't always have to perform, but I just want to be able to get to that level where I can be like the behind the scenes, out putting the package together, working with artists, and becoming part of like a nice team for like an artist. That's where I think I want to be a part of.
And do you have any inspiring words for the up and coming dancers, the youth?
Just be humble and definitely, like I said, networking. Just getting yourself out there. Just even with just going back to the Beyonce video experience, it was when I got in it, I was not a part of an agency. I didn't really take much dance classes. Like, I mean, I had my knowledge I had from my dance team, but we all were kind of untrained dancers that kind of got together. So I wasn't a part of any of that they say that you need. I would just network, had a simple conversation with the choreographer, telling him I want to get into the industry, what can I do, and that sort of stuff. Then he asked me to bring my resume one day to him, and while he was doing it, he was having auditions. And I was kind of there, just standing there, and nobody really told me what to do. So I was just like, oh, this looks like kind of fun. You know, like they're seeing them doing the dance. So I just kind of slid my way to the mat. And I just started to just learn dance because I wanted to learn it because it looked fun. Then I was just doing it. And then when the directors came in, they seen people doing it. They asked the choreographer, asked me to be a part of it, to all the auditions. And the director actually picked me to be in the video. And they called me back and said, okay, we like this video. And it just happened that fast. And the next day I saw Beyonce. Like, it was, I never expected any of that to happen just from a simple conversation. Of just me telling them, I love your work, you know, I want to be in this industry. So it's just all just about getting yourself out there and just getting to know people and just talking to people. Another thing I did, I actually started out doing work study after like the video. I started doing work study at the Broadway Dancer. And I thought it was important because coming back from Albany, I was so engulfed with the school and the Albany, the dance community up there. And I know there's a bigger community down here in the city, but I knew nothing about it. Like, I knew nothing of any of the names of competitions or big conventions, stuff like that. So being at the Broadway Dancing and just being around other dancers, once again, networking, just making friends, I found out so much more information, stuff about different competitions down here, different events, you can do this, just speaking to choreographers from the dance class and stuff like that. So just definitely also taking dance classes, just knowing that you can always be better. Even if you're like a phenomenal dancer, just knowing, that's the way I look at it myself, just knowing what can I do to make myself better, what can I do to get to the next level. If you always have that thought in your head, then, you know, and just taking everything you can get and run with it, you'll definitely go far. And that, I met so many, like, inspirations at the Broadway Dance, and I met Cheryl Murakami, one of Beyonce's choreographers who did Run the World and Ego. She gave me tips on when my knee was injured throughout the summer, how to get back into the game. I met Luan, Beth Brown, like all these choreographers that teach there. They're really humble and sweet people where they're out to just give back to the community and to help other dancers come up and just, you know, achieve and do what they want to do, and which was just amazing.
And how can people find you if they want to have questions for you?
I'm on Facebook. My name is Lewis Perot on Facebook, or you can find me on my email address, FBLOFUSA@AOL.com. You can search that on Facebook, and I'm there.